Hi friends, good evening. Yes guys, snap crash batch, all those who are part of this batch, guys, join in as fast as possible. Jaldi jaldi guys, come on, snap is round the corner. We need to step up our study, we need to improve our studies, guys. Come on, please join in, all those who are joining me for this particular class, snap crash batch, guys. Yes, all the learners who are with me every day in the evening, guys, there is a slight change in the timing. I decided to start at 4 o'clock because it is clashing with the special class timing, guys. So please join in as fast as possible. Yes, just waiting for some more students to be with me at this point of time. Yes, all those who are here, guys, please give me a high five so that I know that you have joined the class. Yes, all those who are joining in, guys. Yes, friends. Okay, let me go into the formalities. Analogies is what we are going to do today. Analogies lecture one, guys, is what we are going to do today. Yes, my name is Harpreet Kaur Dhodi. I've done my master's in English literature. I have a diploma in journalism. 16 years of teaching experience, guys, is a lot. 16 years of teaching experience in teaching exams of all varieties, CAT, MAT, ZAT, SNAP, PGCET, Banking, GRE, GMAT, SAT, ACT, and TOEFL. Today, I'm an educator with hashtag CATLiveDaily. Yes, agenda is analogies. Analogies is a question type which is coming in the SNAP examination, guys. So, see that you stick with me and let us solve some analogies today. Yes, download the Telegram channel, livedaily.me/chat. And join me on this particular channel, guys. I have my own private channel also, which is known as Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy Cat. Yes, this is known as Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy Cat, guys. Yes. So please join in as fast as possible. I'm waiting for all the students who are here to join in. Yeah, so that we can take this class forward, guys. Yes, please. Yes, also guys, I would like to inform you that the CAT subscription is the best in the industry. It is just 3,500 rupees for 1 month, 2,917 for 3 months, 1,458 guys for 12 months, which is very, very reasonably priced, 875 for 24 months. Yes, so please go and take the CAT subscription. The CAT subscription is the best in the industry. You have a lot of inputs by way of content. Yes, you can get the best content, guys. There are quizzes. Yes, there are also what is known as doubt solving sessions. Yes, there is also what is known as a personal interaction with the educator. And then we have the best test series also, guys, coming up. So for all these benefits, guys, I think you should go for the subscription. If you take the CAT subscription, you will be good enough to do even what is known as SNAP. You will be able to do SNAP and ZAT. Yes, so those who have done the CAT examination are almost as good as prepared for the SNAP, but we are only looking at those question types which typically come in the SNAP examination, guys. Hi, Shivani. How are you? Yes, in addition to that, guys, if you use Core 10, you will get a further 10% discount. So please join on to the Plus bandwagon and take your subscription with Core 10. You will get a 10% discount. Not only that, guys, anybody joining any of the courses, whether it is NEET, JEE, any of the courses, guys, yes, any of the courses, you can use Core 10. Right? Yes. Okay. So going to the next slide, we have started a weekday batch for CAT 2021 from December 23rd. Weekday batch, guys, has already started. There is a beginner's batch for CAT 2021, starts on December 21st. It has already started. Again, Revision batch for CMAT is also started since December 21st, guys. So this is all what is happening around us. So if you go for the plus courses immediately, please join for the plus courses and you will benefit a great deal, guys. Okay. Analogies lecture one, guys. I'm just waiting for all the students to join in. I am good, Shivani. So Shivani, are you there on my Telegram group? I hope you have joined the Telegram group, Harpreet Ma'am, Unacademy Cat. Yes, are you on the group? Yes, so let us go into the lecture, guys. How do you do analogies? Analogies are that type of questions. Hi, Sadhna. Yes, analogy types questions are those type of questions which are used, which are not very exhaustive. There are many, many long lists, and as a however, the endeavor of the faculty is to explain it and look at important analogy types which have been appearing in the CAT and management exams. So that is what I am going to do, guys. Yeah, okay, guys. So let us understand what are the relationships, guys. Now there are about 15 to 16 relationships. You cannot mark answers just by looking at the relationship of the stem pair or the head pair as being synonyms or antonyms. Sirf synonym ya antonym ka relationship banaoge to kabhi bhi answer correct nahi hoega. We need to go into a deeper analysis of this, guys. So what you have to do is, let me introduce you to what are the different kinds of relationships, and after that we will decide how to answer these questions. I have many questions coming up for you. Yes, so the first one is synonymous. This is the broadest relationship. For example, salubrious means healthy. Synonyms. Both are synonyms, right? Parsimonious means miserly or stingy. Both of them are synonyms. Pulchritudinous, guys, look at this word. It's a long word. Pulchritudinous means beautiful. Yes, it means beautiful. And hirsute means hairy. Yes, certain animals like bears are hirsute. Hirsute means because they are very hairy, guys. So that is the one which means hirsute. So this is known as a synonymous relationship. Yes, then you have antonymous relationship where both the words are antonyms, right? So opulent is penurious. Opulent means rich. Penurious means poor. Yes, fair and just are opposites. Right, both of them are opposites. Insipid is not having any taste, tasteless. This one is tasty. Ignorant and wise, again opposites. Right, so very often you can find this relationship. I'm going to go to other relationships, guys. Degree of intensity, like is a lesser in what you call degree. Adore is a higher degree. Warm is a lesser degree. Scorch is a higher degree. Right? Similarly, you have drizzle is a lesser degree, and torrent is a higher degree. Flurry. Flurry is when you have a snowstorm. Snowstorm. Flurry is a lesser degree, and blizzard is a higher degree. So degree of intensity. They are giving you one sentence of lesser degree and one of higher degree. Is that fine? Yes, then you have part to whole relationship, like island is a part of an archipelago. Paragraph is a part of an essay. Strand is a part of the hair. Blade is a part of the grass, right? So this is known as the whole and part relationship. Yes, tool to workman. So what is the tool which is used by each workman? Like a surgeon uses a scalpel. A sculptor uses a chisel, a writer uses a pen, a carpenter uses a saw. This is the fifth kind of relationship, guys. Sixth one is worker to workplace, like a doctor works in a hospital, a miner works in a pit, a professor works in a college, astronomer works in an observatory. So what you need to do here is you create a sentence bridge and you apply it to all the sentences, like a doctor works in a hospital, a miner works in a pit. That is the sentence bridge that you will create, and then you will apply it to all the options and you will be able to get the answers correctly, guys. Yes, worker to article. What is he working on? Like a poet works on a sonnet, a dramatist works on a play, An architect works on a blueprint, an artist works upon a fresco. Fresco is like a canvas, right? Yes, a fresco. Now, member to class, like a kangaroo. Yes, a kangaroo is a part of the marsupial family. A crab is a part of the crustacean family. Yes, these are all known as, breakups which you read in zoology, right? A kangaroo is part of this family. Crustacean, a whale is a part of the main mammal family. Frog is an amphibian family. So this is known as member to class. Then you have gender, guys. You and ram. Like, so this is female, this is male, this is female, this is male. Woman is female. And this is male, right? Now, dog will not be stag, it will be bitch. Yes. So this one we will eliminate. Yeah, the order is not correct, right? Yes, let us learn these three. Fine. Okay, coming to the next one is, this is known as collective nouns. So a pride of lions, a flock of sheep, a herd of cattle, a swarm of bees. So if the head pair is using collective noun, look for an option which is also giving you the same collective nouns. Now cry and feeling, like whining is what the dog does, moaning is what the man does, growling is what the tiger does, mutter is what man does. Okay, activity to adjective to quality. Now canine is dog-like. Now there are a list of words where human beings behave like animals. So canine is dog-like, bovine is cow-like. So similarly, you have many other words, like you have feline is cat-like. Go and look at a list of words ending in I-N-E where human beings behave like animals. You will get a very interesting list, guys. Like you also have other words like pavorine is like a peacock. Yes, and then you also have others which are talking about equestrian is like a horse. So there are many words here, guys. Learn these words up. Okay? Yes. So this is adjective to quality. Tool to action. So what is the tool you use? Drill is used to bore. A crowbar is used to pry. A knife is used to cut. A needle is used to pierce. Then subject. Study to subject. These are all known as the ologies. Ologies are all sciences, guys. Different kinds of sciences, make a list of them and learn them up. Like ornithology is the study of birds. Nephrology is the study of kidneys. Philology is the study of words. Paleontology is the study of fossils. Now, if you know, have all these lists, guys, then you will do good with all the analogies. So make a list of each of these relationships and learn them up. Okay? Yes, next one is what is known as instrument to aspect which is measured. Like a thermometer measures temperature, barometer, humidity, speedometer, speed, and odometer, distance. So what is the instrument and what is it that is measured? That is the 15th relationship. 16th is phobias and manias. Kleptomaniac is a person who has a craze for stealing. Dispomaniac is a person who has a craze for drinking. Pyrophobia is a fear of fire. Hydrophobia is a fear of water. So phobias are fears and manias is a madness. Right, guys? Yes, so I'm going to go to the 17th one. From here, we will start the practice, guys, and we are going to do the questions. So I want this to be an interactive class. I want you to mark the answers. Naive is to dash, coward is to bravery. So establish the relationship of these two, guys. Coward and bravery are supposed to be antonyms. So what is it that will fit here? Give me the answer. Come on. Now it is your turn to start responding. Yes. Yes, guys, come on. I want the answers coming from you. Yes, guys, what is the answer? Correct, Ankush. Ankush is giving me the correct answer. Retreat means to go back. Yes, Utkarsh, beauty it cannot be. Stoicism is being very austere or severe. Yes, so the answer will be truth, guys. Knave is like a person who is like a rogue. So he does not believe in the truth. So if you notice, truth is a positive word, knave is a negative word. Coward is a negative word, bravery is a positive word. So you're looking for a positive word here. So a knave is a person who is not truthful. He does not exhibit any truth. He is not truthful. So the answer is C, guys. Fine, Shivani, Utkarsh, Ankush, all giving me correct answers. So let us go to the 18th one. Dash is to ship and telescope is to star. Now it is your turn to give me answers, guys, and give me correct answers. Come on. Dash is to ship, telescope is to star. So you know what is it that you look to view? You use a telescope to view a star, right? So what is it that you use to view a ship? I'm giving you all the clues also, guys. Mark the answers. Come on. Deck, water, periscope, astronomy. Yes, Manish. Yes, Mansi. Very good. So it will be You don't use a deck in order to look at a ship. You don't look at use a deck. Deck is there on the ship, but what is it that you use to view? Therefore, it will be periscope. Yes, guys. Prathna, Shivani, Khan, all giving me correct answers. So, periscope is to ship, telescope is to star. Okay, coming to the 19th one. Tarpaulin is used to cover something when it rains. Yes, tarpaulin protects us from the rain. It protects from the rain. Yes, make that sentence bridge. A tarpaulin protects us from rain. What is this, guys? Yes, what is the answer to 19th one? Yes, Sanyam Sethi, correct. Yes, correct. And apron protects us from stains, right? So you will have to write apron here. It can't be a stove, picnic or puddle. Puddle is a small pool of water. A pool of water is called a puddle. Yes. So the answer is D. All correct answers coming up, guys. Prathna, Ankush. Yes, Khan. All giving me correct answers. Okay. Sniff is to inhale. Dash is to lope. Yes. Yes. What is the meaning, guys, of this? Sniff is a degree relationship. This is a degree relationship. So sniffing is a small shorts of breath. Yes, small spurts of breath is called sniff. This is high degree. So this is supposed to be a lower degree. This is higher degree. So which is the one which will fit here, guys? 20th one. Yes, Utkar, Shanyam, all giving me correct answers to question number 19. We have gone to 20 now, guys. What is the answer to 20? Manish is saying B. No, it is not B, guys. No, it is not B, Ankush. No, it is C, guys. Snip. Snip is to cut a little part of something, a lesser degree. Lop is to cut a big portion of something. So it is snip is to lop. Yes, Mansi. C is the answer. Deepankar, Garg, Prathna, yes, all those who are with me, guys. Snip and inhale. This is snip and lop. Snip and inhale is a degree relationship. It's a degree relationship. So a snip is less intense than to lop, and both of them means to cut. To cut a small part is snip, and to cut a big part is to lop. Okay, let's go to the 10, 20, next one. Hi, Vaibhav, how are you? How are you doing? Yes, outrage, peeve. Again, it is a degree relationship, guys. Outrage means getting angry. Yes, so outrage is getting angry is a higher degree. Peeve is a lower degree. So what is the other one, guys? High degree, low degree. Which one will it be? I'm at least leading you on to the answers, literally explaining the answers to you. Yes, what will be the answer? Outrage is a high degree. Peeve is a lower degree. That means to get angry, peevish. Yes, what will be the answer? Yes, 21, guys. Yes, Manisha, Manish Naidu giving me the correct answer. Yes, Shivani. Answers have to come from you guys. Guys, I've explained all the relationships. Yes, the correct. Yes. Yes, guys, there has been a change in the timing. From today onwards, classes will start at 4 p.m., not 4:30. So see that you are with me at 4 p.m. itself. Yes, answer is A. Very good. Strive is a higher degree. Attempt is a lower degree. So the answer is attempt. Good. Okay. Not shun. Shun means to avoid. Duel is a small fight. Yeah. Curse means badsi zina. To curse somebody. To use bad language. Yes. Okay. Decrescendo is dash, recession is to economy. So recession is the reduction of economy. Very easy, guys. Recession is a reduction in the economy. Decrescendo will be. Yes, what is the answer? Come on, guys, jaldi. Yes, all the 22 students watching me, guys, I'm doing a snap crash batch at 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. is a special class. Please join me for the special class, guys, at 6 p.m. We will continue from yesterday's lessons where we were doing synonyms and antonyms. We did synonyms and antonyms up to D yesterday. So we will continue from E in the special class at 6 o'clock. So please join me there, guys. Yes, so answer will be A. So decrescendo is a reduction in crescendo. Crescendo is a high-pitched voice. High-pitched voice or volume. Yes, so therefore answer is A, guys. It is not finance, boom or volume. Okay? Yes, going to 23. Thrifty dash hungry gluttonous. Yes, thrifty dash hungry gluttonous. Yes, we did sentence correction yesterday, Manish. Yeah, but I think we can continue with vocabulary. Yes, but in the snap classes, we did yesterday words, right, Manish? Yeah. Okay, thrifty dash hungry gluttonous. What is the answer? Thrifty is a person who is very economical, does not spend money, very frugal in spending money. Yes, what is the answer? Yes, the very good. It is avarice. Yes, avarice. Yes, avaricious. Thrifty, avaricious. So this is a higher degree. Again, degree relationship. So a person who is very thrifty is economical, but higher degree he becomes avaricious. Avaricious means being what is known as greedy. Yes, Sakshi, it will self-control is going to be something. Yes, thrifty means controlling yourself. But here, look at this relationship, hungry and gluttonous. Hungry is a lesser degree, gluttonous is a higher degree. So we have to look at this relationship. Thrifty is a lesser degree, avarice is a higher degree. So that is why we have to look at this relationship and choose this answers. Right, guys? Okay, let us go to 24. Privy secret. Yes, privy is sharing a secret. And privy to what is happening in her life. Sharing a secret. Sympathetic is, what will be the relationship? I'm actually creating the sentence bridge for you guys. Mark the answer now, come on. Privy is sharing a secret. Sympathetic is? Yes, 24, what is the answer? Grief, correct. Answer will be grief. So sympathy is sharing grief. Sharing grief. This is how you have to create the sentence bridge, guys. Yes, clandestine means doing something in a very secretive manner. Secret. Secretive. Yes, so this will not fit. Okay? Okay, going to 25. Pallid color, tactless. Pallid means being pale. So pallid means lacking color. This is known as a lack relationship. It's a lack relationship. Like you can say that a traitor lacks honesty. Similarly, guys, yes. So pallid color, tactless. Yes, what is the answer, guys? Yes, correct. So a person who is tactless lacks what? Hue. Hue is supposed to be shades of color. Tasteless is insipid. Verb means full of zest. Yes. So that is why answer will be, guys, which one? Tasteless, tactless, it's not tasteless. Tact means not being skillful. Yes, what will be the answer? Manish is the only one to give me the correct answer. Tactless lacks diplomatic, lacks diplomacy. So a person who is tactless cannot be diplomatic. Yes, he's lacking diplomacy. So tactless, diplomatic, guys, answer is D. Okay, it's not B. It can't be tasteless. Yeah, 25 is D, Ankush, very good. Okay, going to 26, din-odor-garbage. Din-odor-garbage. Yes, odor is associated with garbage. Whenever you see odor, you are reminded of smell, right? Yes, what is the answer here? 26. Yes, what does din means, guys? Garbage is to odor, din is to? Yes, you have to give me the answers, guys. You have to take the exam in a couple of days. Yes, Shivani. Noise. Yes, it will be noise, guys. Din means noise. Din means noise. Odor is, so din is related to noise. Odor is related to garbage. Yes, so it is synonyms, not dark. Din means there is a lot of din. Din means noise, sound. It is related to sound, guys. Okay? Yes, correct, Shivani. Okay. Dash, incising, spatula, lifting. So this is known as what is known as tool relationship. What is the tool used? Yes, dash is used for incising spatula. Spatula is like a flat spoon or a tablespoon which is used in the kitchen to lift things. Like you use a spatula to lift a cake, a piece of cake, right? So which is the one which will fit here, guys? Dash, incising, spatula, lifting. Yes, Manish. Yes, Ankush. Yes, some more answers, guys, jaldi. Yes, he correct. You don't use a truck to incise. Incise means to make a cut, to cut something. So therefore, the answer is C. So scalpel is used by a surgeon. So the surgeon uses scalpel to make an incision, to make a cut in the body. So that is how it is used, guys. A scalpel is used by a surgeon to make a cut in the body. A spatula is used for lifting, right? Okay, guys, great. Now going to 28. Break, shift, minute, dash. Very easy. Yes. 27 was C, Anish. Very good. Going to 28. So break is a part of a shift. So it's a whole and part relationship. Part and whole. This one, you all of you should give me the answer fast, guys. It's just too easy. Break, shift, minute. Yes, break, shift, minute. Come on, guys, jaldi. Yes, the correct, Manish. Answer is B. Yes, minute is a part of the hour. So this is a part and this is the whole. Hour is the whole, part and whole. Correct, guys. Okay, 29. Dash is to service, euro is to jury. Yes. Dash is to service, euro is to jury. Yes, guys, come on. Yes, 29 is A. Correct. Ankush Garg giving me the correct answer. No, judge is not to service. Juro is to jury is the judge. So here it will be Manish giving me the correct answer, Ankush giving me correct answer, guys. It is inductee. Yes, what does it mean? Inductee is a person who is introduced to a military service. Military service. A person is introduced to a military service. Yes, it's not judge. Judge juro is to jury is not the one. It's not this one, guys. Yes, so juro is inducted into the jury. He is introduced into the jury. So an inductee joins the service, a juror joins a jury. It's not judge. So the answer is A. Martial related to war. Sequester is related is means to isolate. Sequester means to isolate, guys. So answer is A. Coming to the next one, ratchet dash grow inches. So you grow in inches, right? You grow by inches. So this is a unit of measurement. Yeah. So what is the answer to 30, guys? Come on. Yes, you have to know the meaning of ratchet. Yes, correct. Manish giving me the correct answer. No, Anish. Yes, correct. Answer is D. So a ratchet grows by stages and height grows by inches, right? Yes, so ratchet means to increase by, say, stages. Grow is to increase by inches. So it is talking about increasing. So therefore the answer is D, guys, not tools. Ratchet is not a tool. It is a kind of a toothed bar wheel. It is a kind of tooth bar wheel, but what is this relationship, you have to decide and then mark this answer. So you cannot be confused with tools. These are all known as decoys. They are trying to mislead you guys. Understand what is this relationship and then mark this. So ratchet means to increasing by stages. It is also a kind of a tool, which is a different idea, but that's not the relationship mentioned here. So accordingly, you have to mark the answers. Don't go wrong with that, guys. Okay? Yes. Cellar is to house, dash is to ship. So cellar is supposed to be, a room in the basement. Yes, a basement of the house is known as a cellar. Dash is to ship. Yes, it is a tool, but that is not the relationship the author is talking about here. So if you mark ratchet tool, it is correct, but it doesn't go with this relationship. Yes, Mansi, you have to understand what is this relationship and find this is to this, this is to this. So the second shade of meaning of ratchets is to increase by stages. Yes. Okay, guys, going to the 31st one, answer is B. Yes, so the ship at the bottom has a hold. The lower part of the ship is called a hold. Very good. It is B, not C. It's not ocean. The ship ka ocean. Again, this can be misleading. Yes, wave is also there, right? If you can mark ocean, you can mark wave also. Look at this relationship. The bottom of a house is called a cellar. The bottom of a ship is called a hold. So both of them are talking about the bottom or the basement. Okay? Yes. 32. Economy, parsimony, dash, rift. Again, it is known as, this is known as a degree relationship, guys. So being economical is a lower degree. Parsimony is stingy, is a higher degree. Yes. So what is the word that will fit here? What is the word that will fit here, guys? Yes, which one? Manish giving me correct answer. It's not D. Rift. No, guys, it's not a river. Rift is not a river. Disagreement, yes, but this is a degree relationship. Again, guys, don't go wrong. Sakshi, a rift is also means a break, right? It means a disagreement. There was a rift in their understanding, but it does not relate to this relationship. This is looking at a degree relationship, which is lower degree and higher degree. So that is why, guys, fissure. Yes, fissure is a huge crack in the earth. Yes, fissure, rift. So fissure is a lower degree, is a crack. Rift is a break, which is a higher degree. Okay? Hmm. Yes, but that is not the relationship we are talking about here, Z. We are talking about a lower degree and higher degree. So fissure and rift. Yeah. Okay. Yes. 33. Admonish, dash, defeat, conquer. Are you guys understanding? Are you understanding how to mark the correct answer? There will be always two or sentences, two or three words which look like the answer. You have to be smart and judicious in marking the answers. That is why knowing relationships is important, guys. That is why I started with the relationships. Yes, defeat, conquer. Again, lower degree, higher degree. So what is the answer, guys? 33. Yes, correct, Ankush. Admonish. Not negotiate. Admonish means to scold. Yes, again, admonish is less intense. Lower degree answer will be. Celebrate. No. Can't be celebrate. Yes, answer is, guys, D, Prathna, berate. Berate also means to scold, and this is a higher degree. Defeat is a lower degree, conquer is a higher degree. They are not antonyms. Yes, they are synonyms. Yeah, higher degree, lower degree. Got it? Okay, guys. Dash is to wheat, lentil is to legume. Lentil is your dal. Right, lentil is to legume, dash is to wheat. Yes, which is the one will fit here, guys? Barley, Z, no. Yes, Ananyu giving me the correct answer. Not badly, guys. No. Nobody giving me the correct answer because probably you don't know the meaning. Barley is to wheat is incorrect, guys. It's not even bread. The answer is spelt. Yeah, you did not know, right? Spelt is a kind of wheat. Yes, guys, spelt is a kind of wheat, lentil is a kind of legume. Yes, lentil is a type. You can say type relationship. Spelt is a type of wheat, lentil is a type of legume. Get it, guys? Yes, Viranchi Pathak giving me the correct answer is D, guys. So you're learning a lot with me today, guys. See that you are able to do these analogies. They look very easy, but sometimes the meaning of a word can be very, very misleading. Yes, guys, coming to 35, we have just few more left, two or three more left, and we are done, guys. So mercenary wages. So mercenary is a person who will not work unless he makes money. So mercenary works for wages. A mercenary works for wages. Correct, Anand. Spelt is correct. A mercenary works for wages. A dilettante works for. Yes, who is a dilettante? Who is a dilettante, guys? Dilettante is a dabbler. Yes, he is a dabbler. He is a jack of all trades, master of none. He does something only for the love of it. Yes, very good, Manish. Pathak. Correct. 35 is A. So dilettante does something because he enjoys doing it, not because he makes money. Yes, enjoyment. He does it for the love of doing it, enjoyment. But a mercenary is a person, even if he lifts a glass and keeps it there, he wants money for it. That is called as mercenary. Yes, not one who is delighted. Dilettante is not one who is delighted. He enjoys doing what he is doing. He is not doing it for the money. He is called a dabbler. He is a jack of all trades, master of none. Right, guys? Okay. Candle will illuminate, dash will cool. What is the function, guys? Candle will illuminate, dash will cool. Yes, last two questions, guys, and we are done. Yes, he enjoys doing what he does, Anand. A dilettante does something like if he does painting, he enjoys it. If he enjoys singing, he enjoys it. He does it for the love of it and the enjoyment, not for the money. You understand that? Yes, guys. Candle illuminate. Dash cool. Yes, Manish. Very good. A breeze can be even hot breeze, right? Yes, a breeze can also be hot. So there is a cold breeze and there is a hot breeze. That is why the answer will be refrigerator. A refrigerator's function is to cool. A candle will illuminate. Illuminate is to create light. Can't be A, guys. You have hot breezes and cold breezes. The desert breeze is hot. Okay? Yes, D is the answer. Last question coming up on your screens. FOP is dash documentary reality. Foppish. What does foppish mean, guys? Yes, all the 23 students, please watching. Like my video, guys. Please like my video. And I am going to take a special class at 6 p.m. where we are going to develop vocabulary, antonym synonym method that we did yesterday will be continued in the special class at 6 p.m. Right, guys? No, it's not D, guys. Foppish is a person who is only concerned with his appearance. Yes, Shivani, correct. He's more concerned with his appearance, looks. Yes, just a documentary is based on reality. Fop is related to appearance. Correct, Anand. A is the answer. So that was a very, very amazing lesson, guys. I request you all, first of all, to join my group. I have a group which is known as Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy Cat on the Telegram channel, guys. Please join that group in order to get notifications about my class. And at 6 p.m., guys, we have a special class. Special class at 6 p.m. Okay? Yes. So I'm going to go, and that is the end of today's class, guys. Yes. Please join me every day in the evening at 4 p.m. for a snap crash batch. Okay, guys? Yes, so that is the end of today's class. From tomorrow onwards, there is a change in the timing, guys. I'm going to start at 9 a.m. Yes, the cat batches, guys, tomorrow morning. Starting at 9 a.m. It goes on in the evening from 7 to 11 on hashtag Cat Life Daily. All those who are taking the cat next year, please join in. Yes, also, this is my Telegram group, guys. Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy Cat is the link for the Telegram channel. Yes, please join Harpreet Ma'am Unacademy Cat link, guys, in order to get notifications about my classes. Yes. Okay, so the CAT subscription is the best in the industry. Please go and take the plus courses if you are happy with the educators. There are so many educators here. Yes, Viranshi Pathak, you must go for the plus courses. Yes, there are live classes, interact with the educator, live polls, leader polls, test series, analysis. All this is a part, guys. And you also have what is known as doubt clearing sessions. So, Please go and download the Unacademy Learning app, install the app, go for the plus courses and get your subscription. I request all the students who are with me today to join me for a special class, guys, at 6 o'clock is a special class. Yes, the CAT subscription is the best in the industry. It is 3,500 rupees for 1 month, 3 months, 2,917, 14,458 for 12 months is the best deal. Best deal, guys. If you're taking the exam 2 years hence, go for this subscription, which is very, very reasonably priced. Core 10 is what you need to use to get a 10% discount. Get a 10% discount if you use Core 10, guys. Yes. Whether you're taking NEET, JEE, 9th, 10th, 11th or 12th, guys, for all these, you can use Core 10 to get a 10% discount. So whether it is you, your brothers, sisters, cousins, anyone who is joining Unacademy can use Core 10. Yes, guys. So subscribe, like, share, hashtag CatLifeDaily. Download the PDF, guys. And that is the end of today's class. Use Core 10 referral code in order to join my classes. Yes. Yes, Shivani. Thank you. Please join the Telegram group, Harpreet Ma'am, Unacademy Cat, and you will get notifications about my classes on that particular group, guys. So that is the end of today's class. Bye-bye.